that's just an example of what he's been doing all night. He's just an amazing athlete. What a power run. He was right in the slot there, just on the left of the post, which for a rifle kicker, perfect there for Osaka. Outstanding.
What an extraordinary game it's been. Again, the second game on Friday night delivers. You know, we saw a cracker last week at Suncorp Stadium. This one is just as good. Fifita's run, did he break six tackles in that run? I think he might have, and got a quick play to ball, which really didn't allow the Eels to put any pressure on. Gutherson was held up there at marker, and Osako, as he did just before the end of regular time, struck it beautifully.
They move into seventh position, Louis. What does this give them in terms of their finals credentials now? And you asked Kevin Walters pre-game, are they just going to make up the numbers, or are they going to give it a shout? Has this helped their cause?
Oh, yeah, definitely. It's definitely going to come out of this game with a whole lot of confidence coming up against the Parramatta side, who's been playing some, you know, really good football. They're sitting up there, they're playing for a top four spot. But the way that they played tonight, and, you know, Payne Haas was absolutely outstanding. David Fifita had a couple of really good carries, scored a beautiful try. But this one here, to win the game, 45 metres out, you've got, seriously, Parramatta players everywhere. Comes up with this play, and then again, just the setup for the field goal, like Benzie said earlier, they're set up to the left, and you've got the two right-foot kickers on the right-hand side. But Milford's selling it, he looks like he's going to get it. It goes in front of him, straight to Osaka, and just nails it. But yeah, well, the Broncos, they're going to be super happy with the way they played tonight. And to get the 2 points, it's huge.
Yeah, a little bit of pressure off.